Okay. All right. Sweet. Hi, everybody. Welcome to a fantastic episode of Mr. KTV. We are getting into a new scenario now. I've got multiple cameras I can use here. Check this out. Ain't this cool? I'm excited. We're filming. Okay, welcome. All right. Today, what I am going to do is demonstrate how to disassemble one of these engines. We're here in the small engines portion of the shop. I am excited to show this to you. So what I've got here currently is a little bit of a setup for what we are going to see when you are doing this on your own in the shop. So I just wanted to show you a few things. We're going to do one thing at a time. First things first, you're familiar with the tools that we're going to use. I'm cheating a little bit here. I've got my cordless drill that I'm going to use with other tools to get this job done. Unfortunately, you will not have that option. I'm going to be as careful as I can not to break any of the bolts on our lawnmower here, lawnmower engine. But I just need to speed things up when I am doing this instead of doing things by hand. What I've got also with me is the service manual for the specific engines that you're going to be tearing down in this class. And I'm going to follow that as we move along, same as you would. So, first things first, I grabbed myself another one of these, I guess you would just call them frames, whatnot, to hold the small engines when we're working on them. And then I'm not cooking a turkey for Thanksgiving. We got some time before that, but I've got one of these bins here in case there's oil inside the engine that I'm about to unbox in front of you. So let's move forward. Oh, it's brand new. How exciting. It's even got this packing material and stuff. Is this another service manual? That's a troubleshooting guide. Let's pull this out. Sometimes these engines come with oil. I have to double check and see if it does or does not. And we will figure this out as we move along. Move this box out of the way for the time being. Bring the engine to center stage. And let's make sure that it's in our shot here. Oh, right. How exciting. Okay. First things first, when we are looking at our directions here, they want us to disconnect the spark plug. So let's see if I can see that. It already is disconnected. That's great. Reason why this is, in case for whatever reason this thing wants to start, there shouldn't be any gas in it. I don't think there should be oil in it, but we don't want to run into a situation where this thing is just running on its own. Granted, it's gonna have the flywheel lock on it right now because it's not pulled back. It should not start. And I don't see any gasoline in there either, which is another good thing. I shouldn't be putting gasoline in there prior to shipping. My terrible flashlight that some of you are aware of. Okay, so we're good to go there. Spark plugs disconnected. Fuel tank is empty. Remove the gas cap. You guys are going to use these little storage bins to do things. Oh, there's a little spark plug in there. This one must have not worked. But I'm going to put this over here for the time being. Okay. But you'll use this to organize your tools. Excuse me, not tools, parts. So you don't get confused when it comes to reassembling your small engine. Drain the oil. Let's take a look and see if there actually is any oil in this thing. I'm just going to rip this off. We don't need that. Okay. Let's see. Let's take a look here. There are two ways to drain the oil from this engine. By inverting the dipstick tube and by removing the crankcase drain plug. I don't believe there is. There's just a tiny bit of oil in there, if there's any. Must have been during assembly. Looking in there, I don't know if you'll be able to see this with the GoPro. There is a little bit of oil in there. So, Let's take a look here. What I'm going to do, I am going to cheat and move forward a little bit here. I'm just going to remove this dipstick tube. Hopefully I don't destroy anything by going ahead of the ball game here. It's all on video if you see it. So I'm going to use a 10 millimeter in this scenario here to take off this little dipstick tube. Pops right out. It should pop right out. Nice. All right, I'm going to put this over here along with that bolt to know that they go together. And I'm just going to use this once again, this tree. Or perhaps I can capture it in a cup over here. Oh boy, that's gross. Whatever. We've got more oil that we can use. But for the time being, let us see. No, this was one of the two ways they did not want us to drain the oil. But I'm gonna do it this way anyways. Okay. Not much more oil in there. I don't know if you saw that or not. But I drained the oil out of this. And we will be putting oil into it when we are done. Got all of my shop rags here. Keep my area clean for the time being. Next step, drain the oil. Okay, did that. Remove the oil fill cap. Dipstick, did that. Tilt engine on side with the air cleaner facing up, which is what we did. This is the air cleaner right here. And drain the oil into approved container. I guess that was an approved container. After the crankcase is completely drained, tilt the engine back to level. We did that. Remove engine cover and insert. So I am going to get a pair of diagonal cutters, which should be right in here. I'm just going to cut this thing off because it's in the way. I don't like it. Hopefully the film's still going. It'd be terrible if it wasn't. We may need this later, so I'll just leave that there for now. Okay, first things first. We've got some little Torx in here. I don't remember what size they are. Hopefully this fits a T15. It's a T15. So, being careful, I'm gonna take my T15 Torx, as you can see right here, with I'll use my 1-inch extension instead, and start to take off the 4 Torx. Bolts that are in here, screws. And when I do this, I'm trying to be careful so I don't just strip out the bolts that I'm working on. I'm trying to, at least. Wouldn't that be terrible? There it goes. I can't twist it back and forth. I know what's in there. These things are barely threaded on there at this point. Which is good. They really shouldn't be super tight. This is just a cover. I really should have brought my magnet tool over here for some of these, because I can't really get my finger in there at this, which is a dang shame. So let's see, needle nose pliers. Can I get them with the needle nose pliers? We'll find out. I'm on the clock. Maybe if I'm smart enough, I can figure out how to put a timer on this for how long it takes me to actually disassemble these things. And now I could, which I may end up just taking this off entirely with those bolts in there and then having them come out that way. Yeah, I'm just doing that instead. All right, being careful, you kind of have to lift up and forward when you're doing this to pull that off. I'm gonna take these two screws out, put them over here in the container. Hopefully this little box we've got is gonna keep them safe. And I'll just place this over here for the time being. Next, we've got remove the 3 hex flange nuts and 2 hex flange screws securing the engine cover. So they're talking about these two, and there's also ones down here. I think these are all 10s. I'm gonna take these off and put this over here to the side. I think that's the last time I used the Torx. for quite some time. Tenors, these are not. These appear to be something else, like an eight of some kind, perhaps. Yeah, they mixed them up on me. How dare they? We'll start with these tens up top here. One, two, three. Three of those. Remove the 10. Bring the 8 over here. And we'll go 1, 2. You know what? I do have my magnet tool over here. I'm cheating. Some of these may not be magnetic. When I say I've got a magnet tool, all I've got is this pocket screwdriver in here somewhere. I should. I'm praying. In my slew of tools. Mr. K is so unprepared. There goes my scan tool. I thought I brought it. I might have not. I think I lied, everybody. No magnet tool. Whatever. Make it a little bit more difficult on ourselves here. Tiny bit of coffee and we'll get back. Do it. Okay, perhaps I can sneak these out with the needle nose. I could just take off the cover again and these will pop out, but I'll try to be a little bit more correct in my methods. One. Two. My fingers are too fat to pull these things out. Okay. This will pop off the cover, and as you notice, the ripcord just comes off too. So we're going to just take both of these off at the same time. I'll just place these right next to each other and move forward from there. Recoil starter. Done. Blower housing. Oh, this just pops off. Also, we have to be careful. Soon we are getting some items here that you have to be considerate of, such as these little washers here. Let's see. Stud spacers, excuse me, is the correct term for these. Stud spacers. Pulling these off, and I'm going to put them over here. I'm going to put this just right here for the time being. It's just a gas cap. What's next? Recoil starter, blower housings off, muffler assembly. So in here, there's going to be two tens that we can kind of see. I'm going to remove this 8, put the 10 on. Pull this off. This might fall through. I'm going to use the needle nose just so it doesn't. Operation. Oh, God. See, that one fell through. But what's going to happen now? I'm going to pull it out. And hopefully I can snake it out just like that. I'll throw these here. I might have to start not using as much space in my part storage here. I'll put the muffler cover over here. This should just pop off now. The actual muffler itself. And it's going to come out with this little heat shield that it comes with too. I'll place these things right there for the time being. Okay, what's next? I already did this, slide the muffler off the studs. Did that remove the heat deflector gasket from the exhaust studs? Did that remove the air cleaner assembly? Okay, let's turn it around. Turn around. I'm gonna remove this knob right here to get this air cleaner assembly off. Carefully removing it this way, as you can kind of see these hooks here will have to be done that way. Moving the actual air filter itself. I'm just going to put these over here to the side. You've got these lockers that you're going to be able to use when you're starting to disassemble your engine, so keep that in mind. Okay, let's see. Remove the two hex nuts and the hex flange screw securing the air cleaner base to the cylinder head and crankcase. These two nuts here, and then this bolt right here. Still tenors, I believe. 10 millimeter is what I refer to when I say that. Removing that. One, two, just trying to be kind of careful. And number three, this one's gonna, I believe, hold part of this in too, so we just have to be kind of careful. I've also got this essential crankcase tube that I just have to be conscious of when I start to remove this air box cleaner. Two nuts and a bolt. I'm gonna keep these together over here. Pull this away gently. We've got two items. We've got this fuel like priming pump that I have to be careful of, that you're gonna take off just like that. And then this one, I'll probably just, this one slides off fairly easy. Air intake, cleaner box assembly removed. Wunderbar. Okay, detach the breather hose from the crankcase, did that. Move the air cleaner base and detach the primer hose from the carburetor, primer bulb equipped modules, only, did that already. Move air cleaner base gasket from the carburetor. I believe that came off with this gasket right here. I'm not going to play with it too much just because it's a bit brittle, and I'm just going to leave it on there for the time being so we can reuse it. This can come off, but I'm going to wait a second here before I just rip that off, because there's a few things we have to be concerned about. Let's follow the orders. Okay, actually just wants me to take it off right now. Ensure the fuel tank is empty by running the engine until it stops. Okay, we already did that. Squeeze the hose clamp and slide it and the fuel hose off with the carburetor hose clamp. Good thing I've got my needle nose pliers right here. I'm going to use these. I'm going to take this clamp, move it backwards ever so slightly, and I should... You're going to want to be careful doing this. I don't necessarily recommend using the hose to twist this off, but it's going to help me kind of break it loose. And now I should be able to pull it off by hand just like that. Now this carburetor assembly should just come off. And that being said, I can remove this governor. What would you call it? Rod linkage. And the spring that also helps keep it tensioned gently without it flying off. All right, carburetor is off. I'm going to put the carburetor in here for safety reasons. It's precious. Okay. Turn the throttle lever clockwise until it stops. Gently push the rod out. So yeah, I pushed this rod up, and you'll see that you kind of have to maneuver it to get it out. And I'll help you with that once we get to that point. I am now going to slide off this heat shield that was in front of the carburetor and this spacer right there. And here's the spacer gasket. I hope I don't break it. Please don't break. I'm going to leave it on there for now. Oh, hold on. Can I get it? Being super careful. I think I got it, everybody. Oh no, I hear some ripping. I don't like that. Ah! Perfect. Okay. Amazing. I'm going to throw these in here also. Perhaps... No, I can't fit them in there. I'm just going to throw them right that there. I'm going to make sure my film is still going. Because sometimes... See, I've got one battery left on my GoPro, which I don't like. We're going to keep going, though. I really hope that this doesn't die on me. Okay. Looking down here. Carburetor with the choke. Disconnecting the fuel line. Squeeze the hose clamp and slide it off the carburetor. We already did that. Oh, this is just doubling down. Remove the governor spring. That's what it wants us to do next. So right here, the governor. Is it talking about the smaller one down here? We'll do this small one first. Just be careful when you're removing this. You may need to use pliers, which I'll use. These needle nose pliers. And for tight space, you're going to be able to grab the bottom part of the spring here and then maneuver it out, if I can figure it out of its hole here. Okay, this is out, which means the top part is easier to remove now too. Let's put this over here. Make sure we're good there. Make sure this is still going. Oh, that's a perfect shot if I ever seen it. Continuing on, what do they want us to do next? Remove the speed control bracket. So that's this whole assembly right here. More tens at this point in time, if I'm not mistaken. Yep. So I'm going to go remove this bolt, try to keep these together, and remove this one. And it did have a third, but that was part of the air cleaner box assembly, just to remind you guys. Okay. I will probably just leave that on there with this fuel tank, which we're going to take off momentarily. I'll put these with that spring because they are part of the same assembly, essentially. Fuel hose. I'm okay with these. Governor Hex Nut. I'm not going to mess with this right now. You will see later on. I'm just going to leave that on there. But I will remove this, so it does not disturb us in the future. The governor spring and rod. I'll just put these also right here. Cool. Okay. Let's see. Removing the fuel tank. There are four things holding this fuel tank on right now. We've got, well, I can remove the one bolt here, which is what I'm going to do. You could remove these two, but why when you could just remove this bolt? And then we've got these. And I'm going to be a tiny bit more careful. I'm a bit reluctant to do what I'm about to do. And they're okay, but you just have to be careful because now I'm just removing this whole shaft instead. This I highly recommend you do by hand. Anytime I use this electric grill, I'm always just hoping that I'm not going to tear one of these bolts, rip it right off, and prevent us from being able to use this fuel tanks off. We're gonna put this over here now. I will be cheating some more in the near future here, removing the ignition module, which is this piece right here. Notice that these look very similar. They are not. You can see that this piece is a bit higher, and there's a different color here too. Probably a different material overall. This one I am going to do by hand to begin with, just because I don't want to damage this ignition module, or this ignition, module, my apologies. Okay, I got that one by hand to start with, and this one by hand. These have a specific clearance between the flywheel that it has to have in order to actually ignite the spark plug, and so they do that before they send it out to the shops for sale. After this is out, it kind of will be stuck to this magnet right here. I probably should have been conscious of that. I'll put these over here. This will come off. This is the kill switch, which I'll get into at a later date. I have to be careful with this. So I'm going to use some needle-nose pliers. Hopefully it doesn't damage. Oh, well, I'm just going to pull the whole thing off, apparently, is what it wants to do. That's easier. Ignition module. I'm going to put this over here also, being careful with it. Magnets on there. Remove the ignition module. We're moving along. Disconnect flywheel brake spring. This is what I was talking about earlier. If this was not here, which it's going to be harder, you can barely pull it off. That's what the this piece on the lawnmower is for, essentially. Something similar. This would be this piece right here. It's going to actually stop the lawnmower from running whenever you're cutting your lawn. So it wants us to disconnect that. And I know we have got, I'm not going to disconnect the spring. And what the remedy for it was, let me make sure I'm still filming. We're still filming. I'm just scared of having the battery die. I'm going to use some zip ties, which you can see are all over the place here. And I'm going to be doing this carefully. I could be messing up my fingers. You notice this string is, excuse me, spring is quite durable as far as its thickness is concerned. So I'm just going to start this zip tie. Come in here with my groove joint pliers that you may or may not have saw earlier. I'm going to give myself some more leverage here. This should be enough to kind of hopefully bring it back. Oh yeah, with ease. That's one. I'm going to use two zip ties just because I don't want this thing flying and destroying my fingers as we disassemble this lawnmower. Let's see. I'm also going to get safety glasses. What a terrible teacher I am. I realized as we're getting to the more dangerous portion of this specific job here. All right, very nice. Sorry about that. Okay. We're back. What do they want us to do next? Remove this flywheel. This is where I'm definitely going to cheat. I'm going to use a bolt, or excuse me, not a bolt, a socket with my gun. Hopefully I can get this off. There's another tool that you will use. Oh boy. When it comes to removing the flywheel, it is a flywheel hold down tool. One thing at a time here. Sorry for the delay. Nice. But it is what we have to use to actually get this bolt off, because otherwise it's just going to spin. It's going to continuously spin, spin, and spin. With this socket that I use on this portion here, the amount of torque that my cordless drill produces should be enough to remove this actual nut here. Too big. Still too big. I had the correct socket over here somewhere. I'm gonna keep trying. Sorry about this delay, everyone. Nice, that's gonna work. And I'm gonna pray that nothing goes wrong here. All right, I'm super happy that worked out. There's a nut. This is a retainer that's going to help it catch the drawstring, so to speak, on your lawnmower engine. This piece will pop off. I'll put this over here. This is gonna be the tricky part, getting the actual flywheel off. Let's move forward for the time being. Remove the flywheel key from the crankshaft. The flywheel is mounted on a tapered shaft. To remove it, use a rubber mallet and a firm blow slightly off center of the flywheel. Can I get it from hand? We've got a rubber mallet around here somewhere, a dead blow. I'm just going to use this dead blow over here. That's rubber. Hopefully this works. Maneuvering this around. Came off. No damage to the flywheel. I'm happy about that. Do not lose this key right here. This is very important. It will prevent your lawnmower from actually, excuse me, your engine from working at all. Okay, I'm going to pause and I'm going to change the battery on this thing because I am very suspect of it. I don't want to lose you guys in the middle of us doing stuff here. So I will return. All right, we're back. This battery is not supercharged either, but hopefully we're good. We'll see. I gotta move quick. I'm gonna move this hammer over here. You know those pliers over here. Breather assembly. I'm not going to remove this, only because when I was putting all these together from last year, it was not removed. So I'm not going to do that. Spark plug. Forget if I've got a spark plug socket. I can't remember if I brought mine here or not. Oh, hopefully this is the right size. It is perfect. This one I'm not gonna use the electric cordless drill for, only because this will cause issues if I try to use that. So I'm gonna hold this down, be as careful as I can. See, look where my arm is, right next to this thing that wants to retract. I think it wanted me to remove that. Got it. Did it want me to remove that whole assembly? Just wanted me to remove the spring. I'm gonna take this off at this point in time because I'm scared. Backtracking ever so slightly, being careful doing it. Another 10. These are weird. You'll see in a moment what you have to be careful of with this. So I've got these two bolts here. They're longer, but they come with these spacers that you can see. Oh God. Oh, saved it right here. Keep an eye on these spacers. If you lose them, you're not going to have a fun time. And I'm going to put this right there. Okay, back to where we were. We were taking up the spark plug. I'm going to try to do this as fast as possible without destroying the threads on the spark plug and inside the actual cylinder head itself. Almost there. Okay. I'm going to put you right there. Removing the flywheel brake assembly. Oh, okay. I jumped the gun. I'm sorry. Removing the valve cover. Four of these bolts here. We get the tenor still. It's not cheating. Flywheel cover off. Boom. Check this gasket out. Oh, there's some oil in there. Oh, boy. Okay, I'm going to try to remove this. I don't have to, but I'm just going to do it anyways. I mean, they want you to, but in this scenario, we'll remove it. Remove the jam nuts and pivots. Okay, so this part also can be... We'll just remove it all in this instance here. We have to be a little bit careful. This is the part where I'm going to have to use an open-end wrench to hold down the bottom part of this here valve assembly. Give me a second here while I get the correct tool. I think it might be an 8 on top here. No, I'm wrong. It's a 10. I might be able to get these off without having to hold the whole thing. Nope, I have to get an open-end wrench. I think it's a 13 on the bottom. Nope, 15, right? 15. Let me go find a 15. Hopefully I've got a 15 wrench in my setup here. There it is. 15. Metric. There might be, these might be some standard sockets. Like, there is a bit of a excessive play with this 15. Now I am suspect of the 15 that I just grabbed, but in fact, let's go get the standard size. Maybe I am eating my own words here. I should know what the direct conversion is off the top of my head, but I'm not gonna lie, I don't. Sorry. Too small. Half inch. Much better. Not as much play with that one there. So I'm going to put my 15 to the side here, but I'm still using the 13 for the top piece here. Okay, that's one. You can see now it's moving independent of the other jam nut on there, the retaining nut. It's tight! Ugh, got it. I'm gonna remove these. I have to be careful though. Springs may want to come off sooner than later. It's a good thing we've got our safety goggles. right there. Rock around pivots from the rocker studs. Okay, these were what? 15s? Not as much play with that for whatever reason. I'm also going to use or start to loosen these by hand just for my own concerns. And there's not too much on them. No, I could use this now. Wow. Interesting. That's strange. There's some dirt or something along those lines on that piece there. Must be from the manufacturing process or something along those lines. I'm going to remove these rocker arms from the engine itself there. Put those in there. And I could, you know what, I'll take these out too. These push rods. They're floating. I don't want these to fall out and get in the way. I'm going to move this up this way so you can kind of see what's going on just a tiny bit. You should be conscious of where, what side these came out of. So I'll put this one here for left. I know you're not really determined what left versus right is, but then I'll put the other one in another box for right. Using the needle nose carefully so I don't really scratch this. Makes it a little bit easier to pull out. Okay, put that one right there. Alright, what do we gotta do next? Rocker arms removed, push rods removed, rocker studs. I'm going to leave some of these things on here. I'm gonna leave these in here because I don't necessarily need to remove them. I'm going to be careful now. My apologies. We can remove the cylinder head bolts at this point in time. 1, 2, 3, 4. I am also going to use, hand loosening method one more time. I'm going to use a little bit larger of an extension. It's going to be a little bit harder because all this torque is transferred through this 6-inch extension now to loosen these bolts. In fact, if I use the 3/8, that'd probably be a better idea. 3/8 drive, that means, which is where the spark plug socket was being used. But let's see if I can get these without actually, see, they're a bit tight. And I am going to switch because that was too difficult for me and I didn't like that. So, let me grab an extension from my tool bag over here. So I can reach down there. This should be enough. Then I'll grab my tapewell 10. Now I'm gonna get a bit more leverage when it comes to removing these cylinder head bolts. Let's see if it's any easier now. Even more leverage. I'm gonna put this down. Son of a gun! One. I'm just gonna do a strange detorquing pattern here. I don't think they specified which way to move them, but I'm just gonna go cross. It's two. I might have done some really bad things if I had tried to use the electrical drill for this portion. Here we go. Three. Did I get the bottom one already? I already got the bottom one, now it's the top one. Four. Now I'll cheat. I'll use the 3/8 drive instead this time. Ooh. some metal shavings from the manufacturing process that just poured out. You can see some more there, or it's oil. It might be oil. Being careful. Okay. One, two, and I already took out three and four. Come on, there we go. Cylinder head bolts out. They gotta find their own storage space. Is this ready to come off? It is. Sweet! Cylinder head assembly. I will have you guys do some valve type things for the time being. I'm gonna put the cylinder head just over here. Can I remove this gasket? Perhaps this ran already. It could, no, I don't, it's gotta be newer, but this is just interesting how it's kind of, alright, there we go. Got a lot of gasket material on there. We'll come back to that when I make another video in the future here. And I kind of keep jumping the gun slightly. I apologize. There are some things here that we didn't necessarily do, such as disassemble the cylinder head. I'm not going to do that right now. I want to get this whole thing disassembled in this video here. Hopefully the video is not too long. It's for your benefit. We already removed the dick stick tube. I cheated. Now we're doing oil pan removal things. Oh, and I got oil on this here. That's not good. I gotta be careful with that. Mr. K's out of control. I'm gonna flip this over at this point in time, because they want us to take off the oil pan now. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bolts that we've gotta take care of. For this also, I will probably start it by hand when it comes to loosening things up. So I'm gonna pull off this 10 millimeter right here. It's got oil all over it, so I'm going to dry it off. Oil pan and gasket. And we're gonna have to use a flathead screwdriver as a wedge, because this is gonna be tightened on there pretty good. But let's see if we can start all these bolts to begin with by hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Great! Too oily. Now I'm coming and cheating. This part might get a tiny bit tricky. Because now I'm going to have to pry the oil pan off from the actual engine block on this 6 bolts. I know I said we're not supposed to use a screwdriver as a pry bar all the time, but it tells us to do that in this here. And there should be a spot for which I can actually do this. I'm going to try to look for the best area so I don't really crack the aluminum case. I like this little spot right here, but that might be dangerous. Let me double check these directions really quick. They don't tell you, but that does look like a fairly good spot. So do I have a screwdriver? Oh, I've got this. This might work. This is my wedge tool that I used quite often back in the day. Oh, there it goes. Sweet! This should carefully pop off. We still got a lot of oil in there. Mr. K didn't do a good job at draining the oil. I'm sorry. Okay, what next? Remove the governor gear and shaft. No, that's here, the camshaft. This should just pop out, which it did. Excellent, that's what I wanted. I'm gonna put this in here. Maybe wipe off a little bit of the oil just so I don't destroy this box. But this is the camshaft. At this point in time, we should know what the camshaft is in mag class. Next, I'm not taking the governor gear off of the oil pan just because I don't need to hitch pin in the governor shaft. I'm not doing this either. I'm going to leave this in there. One of the engines that I've reinstalled, I did that incorrectly. One of you will find out. One of you. Removing the tappets, I'll do that. Either just the pieces here that are going to connect to the push rods to enable us to... Oh, and also you should be conscious of where, which one is which. Let's see. Can I remember left and right? I believe this is the way it goes. You might correct me in the video. Please do if I'm wrong. Connecting rod cap. That is this piece right here. And I'm gonna be able to... Here, let's see if I can turn this. Oh yeah. Much better access now. Perhaps if I do it even more. Perfect. This is where I want these bolts to be, so I can actually sneak my what's it called, quarter inch ratchet right here and get these bolts. I think those are 10s. I have to use a short well versus a deep well now because I wouldn't be able to fit the deep well inside this. This might be difficult though because I don't know how tight these will be. Yeah, they're pretty tight. Be careful when you do this. That's one. I have to move this a little bit more. Class is over. Just kidding. That was in the video. That's not in real life. Sweet. These should be loose enough now. This is the tough part. Now I have to hand loosen these. Just like you all will have to. How disappointing. Is there a workaround for that? Maybe there is. I don't know off the top of my head. My apologies. That's one. One? Can I? Yeah, there we go. I pushed it out so I can get a little bit better access to it. While there's all this oil in here, this is going to be easier to do because it's going to help lubricate these moving components. If you were to put these back together dry, kind of like I did, things get a little bit tougher. These metal-on-metal components prefer to have the oil for lubricity purposes rather than no oil. Okay. I don't think the cap's going to just fall off, so I'm going to have to come back in with my little pry tool. Doop, 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 doop. Let's see. And carefully. Oh, there it goes. Very nice. Move this. Let's just clean a little bit of the oil off of it here. I'm going to throw it. I'll throw it right there with the bolts that it came with. Now... you can see I can move this crankshaft freely and the piston can disconnect if I want to. But I'll push it up just for the time being because I'm going to remove the piston. See, now it came off. Next step, it says remove piston out the top. I'm not going to be able to do it at the bottom. You should see some of these rings expand as I poke this out. One, two, ring expanded, and then there's going to be an oil ring. Ow, third. Piston's out. I'm just going to throw this in there too. Wow, this storage container is working out pretty well. We don't have too many parts left in this here assembly that we have to worry about. I'm almost done. Remove the crankshaft. What's holding it in there? Nothing now. It should just remove. Unless I am mistaken. Mr. K is mistaken often. Okay. I'm going to use a bit of persuasion to do this. But while I do that, I'm going to remove a lot of the oil that was remaining in here just by kind of tilting it. Look at all that stuff. I'm going to come over here with my rubber mallet while it's doing this. Being careful, I'm going to aim this way. I don't want to damage this crankshaft, so I'm concerned. But yeah, I can already see it moved slightly. There it is. That's just going to fall out right now. Turn this block back over. Pull the crankshaft out. Boom. Done. That's a disassembly right there. Good job, everybody. You're right there with me the whole time. And I've got one space left over I could have put this in a slightly different area, but I got one spot left over for parts. There you go. This is the engine block. We've done it, everybody. Thank you for joining me today on Mr. KTV. This is the Kohler small engine disassembly XT6 or XT7. I don't really know specifically what model this is. I could probably find out right here. XT1730037. Maybe I'll ask you guys to do that in this worksheet. But that's it. There's nothing on this page. We're done. Thanks for stopping by. Have a great day, everybody. That's Mr. KTV. I'll see you next time. Come, police, arrest this man. Do 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 do.